Every day, somewhere around the world, a child is born. There are two ways a child can be born, through natural birth or C-section. There is no right or wrong way to give birth. Today, I will be comparing both ways of birth, seeing how they're similar and different. The first thing I'll be comparing is safety. The question of safety can be broken down into two categories. What is the safest way for a child to be born, which refers to the child, and what is the safest way to give birth, which refers to the mother. Both of these questions really depend on the situation. Before I go more in depth about the safety reasons, it may be helpful to know the reasons why women would do C-section in the first place. There are many reasons women would go through C-section, and not only for their own safety, but the baby's as well. There are some infections, like HIV, that a mother might have a chance of transferring to the baby, requiring it to be removed early. This is also the case for large babies, usually caused by a parent's diabetes. A C-section can also occur if a baby has trouble coming out, turning, it's suffocating, or it's stuck. Not all procedures are perfectly smooth. There are some risks you have to be willing to take. During a vaginal or natural birth, one of the risks that may occur is the ripping or stretching of a vagina, which can cause bladder problems if they do a surgery to repair it. Natural birth can also cause lingering pain in the anal area, as well as heavy bleeding and shock. One of the most serious and unlikely risks is death, which can occur in both ways of birth. The most common risk of having a caesarean section or a C-section is the extended hospital stay. Women who have this typically feel more pain for a longer period of time than those who go through with a natural birth. This can weaken the early bond between a mother and a child, since the mother won't be able to hold or breastfeed their child at least a few minutes or hours after their surgery was accomplished. Like mentioned before, death can occur during the surgery, and it is usually caused by blood clots, infections, and anesthetic complications. Of course, before you decide to do any of this, you need to understand that these decisions affect the baby as well. In a vaginal birth, the baby will be less likely in developing breathing problems since fluids will be pushed out as they exit the womb. They will also have a boosted immune system since they receive a lot of good bacteria from their mother. But because of the narrowness of the birth canal, there is a chance the baby will be caught in an awkward position and cause injury or a bruise. There are not many pros to C-section, other than your baby has another chance to live and be in this world. Many things can go wrong. A baby can have breathing problems in the future, and they are a greater risk of stillbirth. It can even be cut during the surgery. Even though both of these options seem pretty scary, there's a small chance that anything I listed above will happen. It is not easy to give birth in any way. Our medical procedures aren't perfect, but they continue to improve. Our technologies are getting stronger and better, making sure both women and babies survive the task which hundreds of years ago was fatal for both. I conclude this by saying thank you for listening and stay safe during these scary times.